Hello, hello, thanks for tuning in. Okay, today we wanted to show you a very portable power unit that you can piece together yourself for a relatively low price without having to get involved in building things. These are right out of the box. You can get them off the shelf on Amazon. Links will be in the description to everything. It costs you guys nothing to click the links and it does help the channel out, so please use the links. If you haven't seen the video on the Renogy Power Pack, go ahead and click the link above. Also, the solar panel there in the rear, we have a video on as well. Click the link above to see that. And it's just plugged in for right now to show you. It's not producing any power because we're inside, obviously. But this little power pack here has a 12-volt cigarette outlet, and we decided to pick up a Energizer pure sine wave inverter. It's 150 watt pure sine wave. It's got little pads here, a fan. It can sit inside a cup holder. This also has two USB outs, but to convert it from 12 volt over to here and then step it back down to 5, there'd be a lot of loss in there, so it'd just be better to use the USB ports off of this. But the reason why we wanted to do this is because we wanted to have some mobile power and to show you guys how easy it is to get mobile power. If you see there, the input has to be 13 volts DC at 16 amps. So this thing puts out 12 volts unregulated, you know, at around 15 amps. So it'll handle this just fine. The output is 115 at 60 hertz, 1.3 amps at 150 watts. We believe the max output on this is 180 watts before it trips. So this has a surge capacity of 300. Most inverters are double on the surge capacity. So 150 constant, 300 surge. You'll never be able to get the 300 surge because it'll trip the battery pack internal sensor. But we wanted to show you that you can run some things off of it, some household everyday items. So we're gonna go ahead and get it plugged in and get the first item up here to show you. Okay, we got the first item set up here. As you can see, we have a kilowatt meter showing the voltage coming out. No amps, no watts yet. 59.7 hertz, so it is clean energy. Let's go ahead and turn on this small table lamp that we have here. And as you can see, it powers on. We are drawing about 5 watts, 0.6 amps. Sorry about the label there. 113 volts still at 59 hertz. All right, so that was a pretty light load. We'll go ahead and hook up a common CPAP machine now. All right, as you can see, the machine is on. We're drawing about 11 watts. We're gonna go ahead and turn on the heater for it. So there we are running the warm up, and you'll see the wattage increase there. So we're pulling about 67 watts, 0.3 amps, still at 59, 60 hertz, still 114. Now we're gonna power it on. And you can hear it running in the background. Wattage shoots up. We're gonna simulate using it. And as you can hear and see, it's still working just fine. So we'll get the next item up, and it'll be a household fan. All right, we have a household fan plugged into it. So fan is too tall to obviously see, but we'll do each setting. That's low at about 35 watts. That's medium then there's high. And again, running the fan, no problem, no electrical noise, no anything. No issues. All right, next we'll get a small dehumidifier plugged in. All right, we got a small dehumidifier plugged in. We're gonna go ahead and turn the power on. As you can see there, it's on and drawing 78 watts. So this is a pretty demanding device here. And it's running it just fine, as you can hear it. And we can even turn the lights off. That'll lower the wattage some. But again, pulling 70 watts, no problem. And again, if you had the 120 watt panel plugged into it, you should theoretically be able to run it all the time in the sun. All right, the next load we're gonna put on is a pretty big load. It's going to be a shredder. Okay, we're gonna shred a whole bunch of paper back to back to see what the wattage jumps up to. We couldn't get the whole shredder in the picture here, but as you can see, it's sitting here. It's a Fellows W6C, and it is plugged directly into the kilowatt meter, which is plugged into the power pack. So we'll zoom in down there so we can watch the watts jump up as we're using this. It's a pretty high demand item here. So you're seeing 118 there. So 120, 126, and as you see there, it handled it no problem. It shredded the papers. The next thing we're gonna do is plug a laptop in, because that'll be another big thing that people might wanna use is a laptop. Okay, we got the laptop set up. As you can see here, it's at 88%. This is a fairly new gaming laptop, so it has a strong processor. And it should pull some good wattage on here. We're just gonna go ahead and plug it in. And as you can see, it started charging over there and we're pulling 54 watts, roughly. So let's see if we can get this thing increased and get some more power getting drawn out of it. Okay, sorry for the loud noise. The best test we can get is playing a 4K video in the background and using our slicing software to go ahead and slice an object up. So you see it jumps up to 90 there, 91. So we're running this thing full speed and it's doing just fine. So it jumped up there at 95. So yeah, all in all, this thing will run many, many different products. Okay, we wanted to add in one more item, and it's going to be a television, because everybody loves TV. So there, we turned it on. And as you can see, it's drawing around 20 watts. TV is on. So yeah, you'll be able to run some televisions and stuff. So yeah, that wraps it up. If you guys like the video, smash the like button, subscribe, share. Again, all these links are in the description with this solar panel, this Renogy battery pack, and the Energizer Pure Sine Wave outlet. This can get you through some tough times if you're out in the wilderness or if you're in a situation of survival where you need to charge something, a light, run your CPAP machine if you need it, medical devices, you know, anything about 150 watts or less, and this thing will handle no problem. So hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.